Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm gonna give you an update of a few weeks alone because I honestly don't think there is any variation on symptoms on the next few weeks. So I'm gonna give you my update of the 7, 8, and 9 weeks of pregnancy. So the nausea has been going on all day long. I have felt also, I just don't feel good, never felt good during those weeks, to the point that it's just like very difficult to do anything, honestly. So when I was 9 weeks of pregnancy, I went to my OB doctor for the first time, and I actually was, I saw a midwife. Their practice have a few doctors, and they also have some midwives. Whoever delivers you is gonna be either a midwife or a doctor, but they wanted me to see everybody, so I kind of decide which one I like best. The hospital itself will always have at least one midwife and one doctor on call, but you can't guarantee that's gonna be the doctor that you chose to be your OB. So I saw the midwife. Before I saw her, I went to the ultrasound technician. She did an ultrasound, and during the ultrasound she told me that everything looked normal. I could hear the heartbeat for the first time. She let me record the video, so that was very nice of her.
This is the baby I measure.
Okay.
Heartbeat.
What is the heartbeat?
174, that's normal.
Okay. My placenta is already formed?
No.
Not yet?
Everything looks good.
Okay. One baby, right?
Mm-hmm.
She gave me a photo of the ultrasound that I'm gonna show you guys. The baby is still very small. Okay, so this is one of the photos, and you can see over here the baby. And then this other picture has like the heartbeat, and then it's very similar. And this one is like more up close. So the baby's here. But she didn't give me any photo there. They are like in a profile way, so I can't really read very well. But that one, I think she's measuring something. Then over here, and then over here. So they're kind of similar. So those were the ultrasound photos she gave me when I was 9 weeks and 2 days. And then after that, I went to the midwife. The first thing she wanted to know if I had any complaint or anything that was bothering me during the pregnancy. And I mentioned that like I have been feeling very nauseated. I didn't vomit or anything like that, but I felt very nauseated. And I asked if she could give me some kind of medicine. And she gave me two options. She gave me an option of a medicine that you have to take it every day because it kind of builds up in your system and only works if you take every day, regardless of feeling nauseated or not. And the second option would be a medicine that I take for nausea as needed. But the only downside for it is that medicine can make people feel drowsy. But I did not want to take a medicine every single day, but my nausea was all day long, so like I knew I had to take some medicine, but I still didn't feel like happy about taking every single day. So I told her, can you just prescribe me both options? And so she prescribed me both options. When I went to the pharmacy, the first medicine, the one that you have to take every single day, she said that it was gonna cost me about $200 and something. And then the second option, which was the medicine that I can take as needed, like whenever I feel nausea, I can take up to 4 times a day, every 4 hours. And that one was gonna cost me like $2. For me, it was like, okay, I'm just gonna take the one as needed because, you know, I'm not gonna pay $200. I was open-minded with that first option, but then once she told me the price, I was like, I think, like if my nausea gets really bad to the point of vomiting, then I may just get that mad. So anyways, I took the medicine that I take as needed. It really, really makes me very, very sleepy. I would be drowsy the whole morning. And then by the time I put the kids for a nap, then I would just go to bed as well. And then whenever the kids woke up, it slept the whole nap, like the whole time. There was one day that I remember that they slept for 3 hours and I slept 3 hours. What I started doing, since I have nausea in the evenings, I started taking like kind of like tolerating throughout the day, and that
the evenings, like at 7, I would put the kids down to bed and then I would take the medicine, at least so I could sleep without the nausea. What ended up happening is that I just go to bed at 8 because I take the med at 7 and by 8 o'clock I'm so sleepy that I just go to bed. In one way, it's kind of good that I actually go early to bed. When I wake up feeling better because I had a very good night of sleep. Versus before that I didn't have the med, I would have nausea during the night. That would make me sleepiness, that would make me wake up, and it was taking me at least an hour to go back to sleep. It was a good thing. I'm just gonna continue taking it and see. I probably would not get anything else unless it gets worse, but if it just stays the same way, I'm just gonna try to work with this medicine, and hopefully my second trimester my nausea will get better. After my 9-week appointment, the nurse called me and she said that during my urine sample that they tested my GBS was positive and that I was gonna have to take antibiotics during my labor. And I was like, what? Usually I do the GBS test at 36 weeks of pregnancy and I wasn't swabbed. That has never happened to me that they, okay, you're gonna have to take the antibiotics during the labor. I was like, okay, no, I said, and I'm gonna request to retest my GBS test. I wanna do a swab like it's supposed to be done. And hopefully, my GBS test will like be more up to date, you know, because GBS tests can change. I know people that had a positive test of GBS and then later they retested and they got a negative. And this can be depending on the diet you're having, like if you start eating more probiotics, if you start eating more yogurt, or things like that, it can change to the point you don't have more GBS. The things you can do to try to avoid taking antibiotics. And I wanted to try that. I don't want to just, okay, I'm just going to take antibiotics, you know what I mean? They were very nice to me. I was nice to them on the phone. And they said everything like can be done, that they could do the test again. So they were very like nice to me about like agreeing with me to do another test. And they put in my chart that I have hypermeresis gravis. It's like a diagnosis for pregnant women that have so much vomiting, that they have so much vomiting going on that they can get dangerous, because if they vomit too much, they can't keep down any fluids or they can't keep down food. Sometimes they can get dehydrated very easily and that can be very dangerous. And so they really take seriously when a pregnant woman is vomiting too much. Well, they put that I had that, but and put excessive vomiting. So I called the office there and I told them, I don't understand why you put that diagnosis there. I have never ever vomited during my pregnancy. I think what happened is that the midwife is under supervision of a doctor, and I'm not sure the midwife can actually prescribe medicines. I'm not sure. Maybe she put that I have excessive nausea to justify the prescription of the medicine that it's the medicine that I told you guys you have to take every single day. Other than that, like this, everything went fine. I don't have anything, no complaints. She did it like a pap smear. I've done it with my first pregnancy, and then when I had my second pregnancy, I had one done, and this is again, I had it done again for this third pregnancy. So in average, I've been having pap smear done every 2 years. I know in other countries you do it every year, but over here in US, I think you're supposed to have one every 3 years. Because of I'm having pregnancies, they wanted me to do a pap smear every pregnancy. So I had that done. That's not like very comfortable. It's like I always feel very uncomfortable doing it. But everything went fine. But anyways, guys, I think that's it for my update. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't. And hope to see you guys in my next one. Bye!